Hey guys, so for number 35, we're going to solve the equation. Now it looks like we have fractions in this equation, so let's go ahead and get rid of those fractions first using the LCD. So the LCD is going to be a term that we're going to distribute into the whole equation, and it's going to get rid of our fractions. To find the LCD, we're going to take into account all of the factors in the denominator. In this case, we have x, we have 2x, we have 3, and then technically we have 1 from the 9 over here. So now we're going to not repeat any factors, but if you did have any repeating factors, you would just take the factor with the highest degree. So when we break down all of the factors that we have in the denominator, we have an x here, we have a 2 here, we have another x here, we have a 3, and then we have a 1. So we do have repeating factors. We have an x here and we have an x here. Since they're both to the degree of 1, we're just going to take into account 1 and we're going to cancel out the other one. So the factors that we're going to take into account for our LCD are going to be x, 2, 3, and 1. And when we combine all that together, that gives us 6x. So let's go ahead and take 6x, which is our LCD, and distribute it into our entire equation. So 6x times 7 over x is going to give us 42x over x. Now 6x times 9 is going to give us 54x. Now the 6x times 5 over 2x is going to give us 30x divided by 2x, and then the 6x multiplied into the 10 over 3 is going to give us 60x over 3. Now let's go ahead and simplify as much as we can. So here our x's cancel out, here our x's cancel out, as well as a 30 over 2, leaving us with 15 on top. And then here, the 60 can be divided by 3, leaving us with 20 on top. So when I rewrite my equation, I have 42 plus 54x is equal to 15 plus 20x. Now I'm just going to combine like terms. So here I have 42 and 15 that can be combined. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract 15 from this side and 15 from this side. And that's going to give me 27. And I'm going to bring down the rest of my equation. And now I can combine 54x with 20x. So I'm going to subtract 54x from this side and 54x from this side, leaving me with 27 is equal to negative 34x. Now to get x by itself, I'm going to divide the x by negative 34. And so my x is going to equal 27 over negative 34. So this negative in this fraction can be written a couple of different ways. You can write negative 27 over 34, or 27 over negative 34, or negative 27 over 34. So now that we found what our x was equal to, we also have to be careful with what x can't be equal to because we have a fraction. Remember, when we have fractions and we have variables in the denominator, we need to be careful as to what the variable can be. In this case, x is the variable. We found out what x was. It was negative 27 over 34. But because the x is in the denominator here, there's something that it can't be because we can't ever have a denominator of 0. So in order to find out what x can't be, we're going to set the entire denominator equal to 0 on these two fractions. So I set my first denominator here equal to 0, and I set my denominator here equal to 0. And it looks like when I solve for x for both of these, I just get x can't be 0, and then I also get x can't be 0 here. So my answer is going to be x can't be 0, x is negative 27 over 34.